Association, Veterans Association. And we have with us Kwame Lillard and Professor Gloria McKissick from Tennessee State University, both participants in the civil rights movement. Professor McKissick, I think we left off with Professor Lillard talking about some of his experiences. Let's look at some of your first involvement with the civil rights movement. I mean, where did it start? It started at Tennessee State University, but when did you, for the first time, sit in at a place? How did you become involved in that?
Oh, the first time was at Wilson Quick, which was a drugstore, lunch counter establishment on Church Street. Again, we were recruited from the student union by Freedom Riders who were expelled from the university. Now the university recently recognized them and they have their honorary doctorate degrees, but at that time they were expelled students and it was quite a controversy around that. But we went down to First Baptist Church for very brief training. Now, actually, the original people who were in the sit-ins got very extensive training. That's one thing about Nashville. Dr. King said that himself, that Nashville was the best, most well-trained, prepared city in the country for sit-in demonstrations. And of course, sit-ins is just sort of an umbrella term for just all kinds of nonviolent activities that can take place to put an end to injustice in the country. Actually, Dr. King identified more than 250 techniques that can be used in a nonviolent manner called Kenyan nonviolence, and the sit-ins is just one, but eventually students will be involved in sit-ins and stand-ins and walk-ins and just facing any place, anything that was involved with segregation. And back then, everything from A to Z in the country was a